Hello, you're welcome to another edition of Healthy Lifestyle Africa on CRBC 105.5 Paradise FM Calabar. Don't forget this program is put together by Asiukpo Diagnostic and Medical Center at Mary's Lesson Avenue in Calabar. Today on the program, our lifestyle expert, Mr. Sunday Clement, will be talking to us on the topic, No Exercise, No Food. No exercise, no food. This means that exercise and food go hand in hand. Stay tuned to the program. My name is Erim Egger.
You're listening to Healthy Lifestyle Africa, a program that gives you information on how to prevent diseases. Our crew spoke with some members of the public to further emphasize the importance of exercise. Let's now hear them.
Food is like one of the most necessary things a human should do. Like you should eat to grow. So exercise is more like something to just help you shape your body well.
As a human being, you have to eat, but not much. And it's good to exercise also.
Well, exercise is very important for as long as human beings exist. Because exercise keeps you fit, makes you smart, and it helps in food digestion, if I may say.
Most of our people now, when they eat, they don't want to exercise, at least to burn the calorie. You understand? So you realize that at times it gets to the point they cannot even walk.
As for exercise, I think it's a very important aspect of good health. Like in exercise can be a substitution for like fruit. After eating fruit, even though you don't have this fruit, you may not be able to eat fruit every day, but exercise can stand there as a substitute to balance this health and help you in digesting this food in the process.
When we really talk about exercising and eating, when we talk about exercise and eating, you can eat and refuse to exercise. All depends on your thought. And you can also eat and exercise. It also depends on you. But in real sense, it is good to eat and exercise.
Exercise is as important as food. Let's now hear from the expert.
It's Healthy Lifestyle Africa, and I did say we'll be looking at no exercise, no food. I have with me an expert, Mr. Sunday Clement. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Mr. Rim.
Well, sir, by way of background, let's just look at no exercise, no food. What do you mean here?
Over the years, people like food, but they don't want to do exercise. I wouldn't believe that the reason why we eat is for us to have energy so we can do a lot of physical activities, you know. But over the years, life has become more comfortable. In the past, people want to go to farm, they want to go to their place of work. There was no car, they have to use, if you don't have hearse, you have to use a cart or
your bicycle.
Even it was even later cart came into play, you know. So you use bicycle. Over the years, we are used to our cars, we are used to conveniences. You want to post a letter, you want to take a letter somewhere, you can email it to someone. And over the years, our physical activities have actually reduced. And that brings the importance of a modification to our lifestyle. And that has a cost on our health. It is therefore important for us to understand that we need to now make deliberate efforts to bring up an exercise plan in order for us to balance our health. To have good health is not just by chance. You have to deliberately work towards it. So exercise should be as important as food.
Okay, sir. Actually, exercise and food. And if you ask me which of these comes first, I'll tell you food first, because you need food for any other thing to also take place. From your perspective, exercise and food, what should be given more consideration?
I believe both are very important. And if you know food is important, you should as well consider exercise to be as well important. Because when we talk of exercise, it's not just limited to, you know, jogging in the morning, you know. It depends on the kind of work you do. You know, some people, their job is just for them to sit in the office, you know, and they do their job. They sit on their computers and they do their thing. And you ask them in the morning, did you do anything jogging around. They said no, you know, they just came to the office and they drive back home. So that's just their life. But over the years, you ask them, have you taken food today? Like, yes, I had my 3 small meals. But the question is, you are kind of storing up energy, and where are you going to use them? That's the question that comes to mind. Where are you going to use this energy? And the body is designed in such a way that when you eat food, the little that you used is going to be used, and others will be converted and stored. There's a kind of warehouse in our system where food energy are stored. You know, they are stored mainly as glycogens. We can call them fat. And it is believed that there will be a time you actually need those energy. But over the years, people, because of their routine, they don't get to do anything to burn off those excess calories that have been stored in their system, and eventually becomes a problem. So I would say both are very important. And in fact, if you would ask me, I would say exercise is even more important than food.
All right, it's no exercise, no food. But actually, I did say in some of our previous editions of this program that there's a saying that you can eat your breakfast, share your lunch, and forget about your dinner. What's the meaning of that?
Yes, you can share your breakfast means that you shouldn't eat so much in the morning. When you wake up in the morning, you should just break your fast. That's why they call it breakfast. You expected that between night and morning, you were actually fasting, and when you woke up in the morning, you are expected to break the fast. So you just take something light just to, you know, to start going in the morning. And the lunch, you can take, you know, share your lunch with someone. And evening, you should take something very light. So people look at benefiting from meals based on the quantity of the kind of food that they eat. But they don't understand that, look, it's not about the quantity. It's about the quality of what you take. Because when you take a lot of food, when you need about 1,500 calories of energy because of your routine, you know, only need about 1,500 calories of energy per day, and you consume about 5,500 calories. When you come to a particular age, there'll be a time you have to battle with the excessive calories you are storing into the system, and that could be very costly and very expensive, you know. So that's why it's important for people to be aware that they need to pay more attention to the content of what they take, pay attention to the quality of what they take, not the quantity.
Okay, actually, we're looking at breakfast, dinner, and lunch, and of course, dinner now. What do you think is the appropriate time to take your dinner? Why is it that you don't need much quantity?
It is recommended to take dinner 2 hours to when you go to bed. So, irrespective of the time you go to bed, you take your dinner 2 hours earlier before, you know, some people go to bed like 10 p.m. So, you take your dinner
By eight,
you know, thereabout, so that you give the body enough time to digest before you lie on the bed. So that is what is recommended.
So are you saying that when you lie, digestion does not take place?
It slows down digestion. Okay. You're expected to be in good position to sit upright at least after eating your dinner. So you're expected to be awake and actively be active, you know, before you eventually go to bed.
Okay, but does eating position actually matter in this case? We are talking about exercise and no food. We are sitting position in respect of taking your food. Some people can lie down and eat and all of that. You know, because we're looking at exercise and food, and they two go together.
Yes, lying down is not a good habit. It's not a good habit to lie down and eat, because the food can regurgitate and can be very risky. So it is not advisable to lie down and eat. But when it comes to importance of exercise, it cannot be overemphasized. That's the reality. It cannot be overemphasized. If you don't have physical activities, you see, the point is that when you wake up in the morning, a mechanic will tell you that before you move your car, you should let the engine run, you know, let the engine run for some time before you now engage it in gear, you know. And people observe, you know, people are so religious about ensuring that these things are well done. But when it comes to ourselves, you know, our heart works like a pump. It works like a pump, and during the day, we might not actually do something that will actually push it, you know, to really expand it, you know, kind of increase the capacity, or maybe mount some kind of pressure, increase the workload on it during the day. And that can go on for weeks, even for months. That is why the program of exercise, it's very important, because when you wake up in the morning, you can decide to do it maybe once a week or twice a week, you know, but when you do your exercise, 30 minutes max, it's recommended. Minimum of 30 minutes is recommended. But if you do exercise and you have chest pain, or you have problem in breathing, or you have pains in the chest, it is very important for the person to go and see a doctor. So if you know that you have medical problems, heart related problems, it's important you go with the guide of a medical physician to guide you. But if you don't have any problem with your chest pain, or you don't have difficulty in breathing and all that, it's very, very important to have exercise plan, good exercise plan.
All right, maybe we get to talk more about exercise plan, but in the meantime, there's a question I'd like to ask you. But okay, in case you just tune in, you're on to CRBC Radio, and of course the program is Healthy Lifestyle Africa. Today we're looking at no exercise, no food. Now let's look at the morning. We woke up in the morning. You start off with exercise or your food?
When you wake up in the morning, you start with exercise. You exercise yourself before you take your food.
Can we know exercise time that could be taken in the morning?
Well, just by, you know, having brisk walk, like walking very fast around your area, is that's number one. Some people have treadmill in their house, they use it too. Then stretching is a form of exercise. You know, you stretch your body. There are different kinds of methods that are used for that. And it's also important for people to register in one or two gyms. They have professionals there that can guide them on types of exercises that are good for them. So exercise is very important. It has a lot of benefits that we can't be saying.
Okay, so again, we're looking at food, we're looking at exercise. Are there some food we can avoid, we'll try to avoid, to ensure that we lead a healthy lifestyle?
When it comes to the kind of food you should take, you take something light in the morning, depends on what you want. So something light, and I say, even so, I told some people that you can even take carbohydrates in the morning,
but a very,
it's
small
a function
quantity.
Yeah, it's a function of quality, not quantity. So if you want to take something in the morning, take something light, you know, and in the afternoon you can take something okay, then evening you can take something
light again,
you know. But ensure that what you take, it's of high quality. And so it's not in terms of size. So any type of food is okay.
All right, so we must exercise as well as eat. The two go hand in hand. Any other information you have with respect to this topic?
Okay, exercise is very good. It has a lot of benefits. It has a lot of benefits. People can check it out on their own, and they can see their doctors. They can as well advise them more on the kind of exercise they can do, and importance and the benefits of doing exercise. It's very, very important. When you do exercise, you have a chance of increasing your lifespan.
So you engage yourself in exercise.
Yes. Then you have a very high chance of not having heart-related diseases. Because the point is that the food that we eat, some of them, they contain cholesterol and they are stored along the blood vessels. Some of them are deposited even in the heart. So when you do exercise, you stand a chance of burning off these things. Because if you do normal activities, those things might not be taken off. But when you do exercise in the morning, it helps to take them away. Then it helps to burn calories, unwanted calories in the system. It helps to burn them off. Then it also helps you in the morning. You know, when you do exercise, you sweat. So you sweat very well. And it has a way of helping you to get hydrated, because you'll be thirsty and you take more water. So, and it helps you throughout the day, because you just have this affinity for water throughout the day. So you take water and you enjoy your activities during the day. You know, just like you had to go, maybe your job requires you to climb staircases, and you went the first time, they say, okay, this is not correct, you have to go and do it again. You go again and you want to go again, and you feel like you start feeling so reluctant, you know, on your job, because you feel you are getting tired so easily. If you have a lifestyle of exercise, all those things are taken care of, so you don't have the reluctance or the resistance. you know, to do whatever you have to do to get your job done.
All right, so much information on the program Healthy Lifestyle Africa, powered by Asupo Diagnostic Center, Merisleso Avenue in Calabar. It came to you on CRBC Radio 105.5. I'd like to remind you that you need to send a text message in case you want to be part of the program. Please don't call, just send a text message to 0803-6755-958. Please let me emphasize again, you don't need to call, but just send your message through the number 0803-6755-958.
Next week, the fun continues right here on the same station. Tune in to Healthy Lifestyle Africa on 105.5 Paradise FM Calabar every Friday at 9 a.m.
It's been Healthy Lifestyle Africa. And so today we looked at food and exercise. The two go hand in hand. You don't need to eat food and just sit one place. You could have some side effect. You need to exercise your body. That's the message today. I'd like to thank Mr. Sunday Clement for coming on the program.
Thank you very much for having me.
On the same time next week, when we hope to bring you yet another important edition of this program. My name is Erim Egger on behalf of the program producer Stella Ethiopia. Join us again.